everyone. I'll just try to keep it very short. It's going to be a very short presentation about the SUPRABHA program. I'm Himangjit, I'm from EY, and we are working with World Bank, SBI, and MNRE for this SUPRABHA program. So I'll just talk in brief about what the SUPRABHA is and what it has been doing in India. So the SUPRABHA is a technical assistance rooftop solar program, which was conceptualized in 2017 as a supporting structure to the $625 million USD loan that was given by World Bank to SBI for propagation of rooftop solar in India. So when it was conceptualized in the year of 2017, this program was supposed to start in 14 states, but now it has moved over to 17 states. As you can see in the map, like from the western sunny regions to the northeastern not so sunny regions, it runs in 17 states of India. When it was started, the program was supposed to work under this following broad themes like policy and regulatory, media and outreach, process streamlining, where we have helped banks, SMEs, we have worked with different stakeholders, and also knowledge exchange. Knowledge exchange is like what we have learned from one state and we pass on to another state. So those kind of learnings. So this entire program was designed as per this six themes, with the ultimate objective of helping SBI disburse the $625 million loan that was given by World Bank. So these are the program partners, like EY is the PMC, along with five other partners who are experts in their own rights, like Skill Council, they work for the capacity building, Edelman, they work for the media outreach and so on. So some of the key results that were obtained as part of this program are like we have helped Madhya Pradesh, Delhi, Bihar, Assam, all the states in the demand aggregation programs that are currently running in these states. So as of now, we have aggregated around 175, helped in aggregating around 175 megawatts of rooftop solar. Apart from this, we have worked with FOR on updation of net metering regulations. So those regulations have been, like we have presented it to FOR, they have approved, and soon a report is going to be generated on that. Apart from that, we have also worked on easing the financial difficulties of MSMEs regarding getting loans or support from banks for incorporating rooftop solar into their systems. So that is one major work that we have done, and the report for that is also going to be out next month. Apart from that, the stakeholder, the capacity building program is a big part of this scheme. So we were entrusted with supporting the capacity building of entrepreneurs, lenders, mostly SBA officers, developers, and so on. So as of now, as you can see, around 527 stakeholders have been trained in different training programs conducted all over India with our training partner Skills Council. So this is a little bit detailed thing about the net metering regulation that we have worked on with FOR. So as I told you, like the report has been submitted to FOR and it will be published around next month. So there we had done some revenue impact on DISCOMs and had come up with a few innovative business mechanisms, business models. Next, we have worked, as I said, we have worked on policy and regulatory issues also, mostly in some states like in the Northeast, like Sikkim, Meghalaya, Nagaland, which where the rooftop solar policies were not very much in place. So we have, before going with the devising of these policies, we have conducted senior management programs out there where we have collected all like the senior state government officials, DISCOMs, SNAs, and we have taken their feedback as to what are the key requirements for their particular states. And accordingly, we have tried to devise policies for these states. Next is that the work with the MSMEs that we have done. So the work, it involved working with MSMEs, lenders, developers to find out what are the key barriers that are impeding the uptake of rooftop solar in MSMEs. So it was around a 6-month program. And after all the stakeholder discussions and everything, we have come up with a framework, with a financial and also an operational framework, where we have tried to come up with a financial mechanism to support lending for MSMEs. Apart from this, as I have told you, like we have done this capacity building programs for different, like for SBI officials, for master trainers, for utility engineers in different states. So these have been conducted over the last 1 year or so. Apart from this, another major work that we have done is the demand aggregation in various states. So this is basically the demand aggregation flow that we follow. So we help the states in the making of tenders, PPAs. Then we also help them in reaching out to the stakeholders, like the consumers or the developers and all this. A key feature of this demand aggregation program was the data room that we created for MPU VNL in the recent biddings that happened in MP. So this was basically done to bridge the information gap that was there. Like developers, they are not so sure about the potential that exists, where to bid and what to bid for. So we made some on-site and off-site assessments, and we came up with a data room where we had information like the site coordinates, solar PV layout generation data, etc. And we gave the information to the developers, and it made it easier for them to bid for the projects that they where they thought would give them the maximum benefits. So this is just a snippet of the data room, like on-site and off-site assessment of this one, of the sites. This is again a result of what was done in MP, like a pricing of 1.91 was discovered for universities with a 3% per annum escalation and all those things. So apart from this, like, we have also helped some states on the in creation of unified web portals, which bring all application approval and implementation under one roof. So that is another work that we have done. Apart from this, we have created a nationwide branding for MNRE, and also we have helped different states like MP, Chhattisgarh, etc. in their bidding process, where we have also supported them in the media and outreach. Finally, this is the last slide, and like this is the ecosystem that we see in 2022, where DISCOMs there at the forefront. Then they come up with good support to the borrowers. Policymakers are there with sound policies, and so basically these are and capacity building programs have created the backbone for the system. So these are some of the basic things that we want to see in maybe around 2022, and for which we are working as of now. So that's all from us. Thank you.